AMD's FSR is actually You must have probably heard about upscaling tech like NVIDIA's DLSS. Apart from NVIDIA's DLSS, what if I told you that AMD's FSR is quietly becoming a game changer even if you don't own an AMD GPU or even a GPU at all? Stick around till the end, this could save your money and boost your FPS. I am Anurag, you are watching Layman, so let's begin. Let's start with the basics. AMD's FidelityFX Super Resolution or FSR is a clever trick to boost gaming performance. Instead of rendering your game at a full resolution, which is demanding, FSR renders it at a lower resolution and then upscales it to match your screen. The result? Higher frame rates without needing a super expensive GPU. And here's the kicker. FSR works on almost any modern graphics card. AMD, NVIDIA, even on Intel. FSR is open source. That means developers can easily integrate it and gamers aren't locked into one brand. Now to begin with, FSR wasn't always this good. FSR 1 launched in 2021. The first version was simple but required anti-aliasing to smooth out jagged edges. It worked, but the image quality wasn't perfect. FSR 2 launched in 2022. This was a massive upgrade for FSR users. FSR 2 uses temporal upscaling, meaning it analyzes previous frames to predict the next one. Sounds familiar? Yeah, it is a lot like DLSS now. But the best part? No need for anti-aliasing, as it can handle everything on its own now. FSR 3 came in 2023, in which AMD added their secret sauce. Frame generation. This tech creates extra frames between real ones, doubling the FPS in some games. And guess what? You can even combine it with DLSS for better performance. Now, after knowing all of this about FSR and DLSS, oh wait, you don't know what DLSS is? Here's a video for you, go check it out. The big question now is which is better, DLSS or FSR? DLSS uses AI trained on NVIDIA's supercomputers. It's incredibly polished and often looks sharper than FSR, and provides better performance boost. If you have a NVIDIA hardware, great, you can go with either of these options. But in my opinion, AMD's FSR is actually better than DLSS in many other aspects. I know some of you may find me crazy, but hear me out for a moment. FSR is open source, it's developer friendly. It can run side by side with DLSS. It can run on any hardware. Even if you don't have a dedicated graphics processing unit, you can still use it. So there's a lot of flexibility using FSR. Also, according to Steam's hardware survey, 76% of the gamers have NVIDIA GPUs. But for the remaining 24% or anyone on a budget, FSR is a great alternative. And with FSR 4 around the corner, the performance gap could shrink even more. Also, as per previous tests and benchmarks done over the years, AMD has always offered better price to performance ratio. So if you are Team NVIDIA, you may stick with DLSS, but for everyone else, FSR is your ticket to smoother gaming. No upgrade needed. At the end of the day, it's your budget, use case and hardware that should decide which one is right for you. And that's it for this video. What do you think? Are you on Team DLSS or FSR? Drop your thoughts in the comments. And also don't forget to like, share and subscribe for more such tech breakdowns. See you in the next one. Bye.